Hi there, welcome back. This is the 14th video of this series, and in this video I'll tell you what is Epic and how to use Epic in agile software development. I'll teach you how to work with the Epic in Jira. So let's move forward and see what is the agenda of the video today. In this video we will learn what is Epic and why we use Epic, how to create Epic in Jira, and how to break down Epic into the smaller stories, how to link backlog stories with the already created Epic. So now we will see what is Epic. An Epic is a large body of work that can be broken down into a number of smaller stories, or sometimes called issues in Jira. Epics are delivered over a set of sprints. Means like Epic captures a large body of work, and it is essentially a large user stories that can be broken down into a number of smaller stories, and it may take several sprints to complete an Epic. Now I told you what is Epic, but why we use Epic? What is the benefit of using Epics? We'll see why we use Epic. So epics are the helpful way to organize your work and create hierarchy. It helps to organize your work. And the idea behind the epic is to break down the work into shippable pieces so that big projects can actually get done and you can continue to ship your value to the customer on a regular basis. Let's suppose you are a product owner and you are working in an organization and you are using Epic. Then in which way it will help you? If you are using Epic, then you can simply have the ability to orientate yourself in the parts of the products and know what you have or what have not finished yet. You can track this easily. You can change the order of the features in the Epic very easily, which leads to the creation of rapid delivery of minimum viable product increments. So if you are using Epic, then it will make your life easier. Now I told you about the Epics and why we use Epics. Now move forward to see how can we create the Epics in Jira. And for this, we have to go to our Jira cloud instance. So let's go. This is our cloud instance and this is the backlog page. So we have the two ways of creating the epics in Jira. First one is just simply click this plus icon and you can choose the issue type of epics from this list. So this is the first way you can create the epic in Jira. Now we will see the second way. The second way is you can create the epic from the backlog, and you can see we have the two options in the vertical menu. One is versions and the second one is epic. Just click here and you will be able to see the list of the epics that we have created already, and you can create the epics from this bar by clicking this link, which is create epic. So once you will click on this create link epic, it will give you the window where you can write the epic name, the summary of the epic, and just press the create button and it will create the epic for you. For now I am canceling it because I want to describe the other things here. As you can see, I have the two epics which are already created. One is allow users to add new contact that we created in our previous video, and this one is the second, selecting marketing campaign. So as I told you, Epic is a large number of requirements which you can broken down into the smaller stories, and you can see this is the selecting marketing campaigns, and when you will click it, then you can see we have the three issues under this Epic. It means we already divided our Epic into the smaller user stories, right? And we can create the epics from here. And the second one is we can create the issues under the Epic from here as well. So there are the two ways you can create the issues in the Epic. First one is just click this epic and it will give you an option to create some issues under this epic. You can see when I clicked this select marketing campaign epic, it gives me the three issues, although we have the total 10 issues in our backlog, but it put a filter as per the epic's name and it is showing me the three issues. You can see 3 of 10 issues are visible. It means these are the three stories which are comes under this epic, and you can see this label as well, this label showing the label color and the name of the epic. So this is the first way. You can simply click here, you can choose the type of the issue, maybe story, task or bug, whatever. Let's suppose if I am writing as a user, I want to create a test story and press the enter key. You can see a story which is come under the selecting marketing campaign is showing here. Now we have the 4 issues under this epic. And once you will just scroll down this bar, you can read down the description of the epic. Like, as a VP marketing, I want to review the performance of the historical promotional campaigns so that I can identify and repeat profitable campaign. This is the summary of this epic. And we have 4 issues and 0 are completed, 4 are unestimated. We did not estimate any story yet. That's why it's showing unestimated 4 and estimated are 0. So this is the first way that we can create the issues under epic. And you can see this is the second way where you can create the issues in epic. Once you will click here, it will give you a window and you can choose the type of the issue. Right now I'm choosing a story 1, and you can check your project as well. Right now I'm using a project test. And once you will write the summary, description and scroll down, you can see the epic link is already mentioned here. Right, the epic name is already here. So this is the second way you can create the issue under epic. Now we will go step by step and I will create an epic firstly, then we'll divide these epic into the smaller stories, and I will link some other stories that are already exist in my backlog to that epic. So let's move forward. I'm gonna create a 1 epic. I click on create epic and check the project name, issue type is epic, and I'm gonna to write the epic name. Maybe I can write down epic 1 for example, and I can write down a summary just like as a bank. We want to extend our services by offering life and health insurance, right? You can write the name of the epic as per the summary, it's up to you, but just I'm telling you as for the testing perspective. So right now I'm gonna click on the create and it will create a epic for now. I am going to clear all the filters from the backlog, and you can see in this epic bar, let me just make it minimize, and you can see this is my newly created epic 1. This is the epic description here. Right now I have 0 issues under this epic, no completed, no estimated and no unestimated, right? Now I'm gonna to create and I'm gonna to divide this epic into the smaller stories. I will click and it will show we have the 11 issues in the backlog, but 0 are related to the epics 1. I'll just create this and I'll write this story 1, or you can write this story as per your epic. I'm just giving the demo here. So I'll click on the story 1, So you can see this is the epic one. This is the name of the epic and this is the color of the epic. If you want to change the color of the epic, you can simply click here and you can change it like this. Now the color of the epic is changed and it's showing one issue and unestimated is one. Now I'm going to create an issue using the second way. So I'll click here the create issue in epic and I'm gonna to create the second story. And when I will, let's suppose, set the priority here, and when I'll come into the epic link, the epic one is already here. I will click on create and you can see right now I have the two stories under epic one. So I'm gonna clear the old filters again and I'm just going to close this panel. Now the thing is this, let's suppose I have a one story which is related to this epic, but it is not showing when I going to this epic and when I will going to this epic one, and it is not showing here. Let's suppose if I will clear the filters and I'll see, let's suppose this story, as a visitor I want to log in, this story is related to epic one, but when I click here it's showing only the two stories. Why this is happening? Because you can see when I will go to the backlog, the story one and story two are already linked to epic one, but the story PT8 is not linked to epic one, because you can see there is a no label is available here. Now what should I do? How can I connect it? You can connect it in this way. You can click here. It will give you a detail window and here you can see we have the name of the story, the status and description of the story we didn't mention. You can write down the description here and you can assign this story to the users. As of now I'm gonna to assign this to myself only. Yeah, and let's suppose I'm gonna to estimate this story with a story 0.4 as just for the demo perspective. And once you will click on this, you can see here we have the epic link option. You can click and you can find out our epic. This one is epic one. Okay, close it. And you can see now as a visitor I want to log in, the story PT8 is now linked to our epic one. Now you can see the issues are three showing here. So once you will click, you can see the three stories are under this epic and we have estimated this story with the story 0.4. You can see the story point is showing here, and when you will come into the left bar, you can see there are the three issues 1, 2, 3, and unestimated are two. Story one and story two are unestimated and one is estimated with the story 0.4. So this is the way you can create the epics in Jira and you can manage your work with the help of the epics. Now I'm gonna to clear my whole filters and you can see there are the three epics in this project test, and one we created in this video, these two we created before. And I hope you like this video and now you can create the epics in Jira and you can use for your project. Please feel free to ask your question in the comment box and share this video to the needful person and subscribe this channel. You can get more videos of the Jira. Thanks for watching. Thanks a lot.